Now, we have already had a quick introduction about Python. Let's understand some advantages and facts about Python in this video session. Now, we've discussed many other advantages of Python, and we know that it is a well-designed programming language also. But not only this, in addition to this, Python is useful for accomplishing real-world tasks as well. Like the sort of task developers do day in and day out, and it's commonly used in a variety of domains as a tool for scripting other components and implementing standalone programs. In fact, as a general purpose language, Python's role are virtually unlimited. You can use it for everything from website development and gaming to robotics and spacecraft control, almost everything. However, the most common Python roles currently seem to fall into a few broad categories. Now, these few sections that describe some of the Python's most common applications today, as well as tools used in each domain. The first one being systems programming. Now, Python's built-in interfaces to operating system services make it ideal for writing portable, maintainable system administration tools and utilities. Python programs can search files and directory trees, launch other programs, do parallel processing with processes and threads, and so on. The second thing you can do is GUIs, maintain GUIs. Python's simplicity and rapid turnaround also makes it a good match for graphical user interface programming on the desktop. Python comes with a standard object-oriented interface to the TKGUI API, which is called Tkinter, that allows Python programs to implement portable GUIs with a native look and feel. So Python GUIs run unchanged on Microsoft Windows, Unix, Linux, and the Mac operating system. We also have internet scripting using Python. Now, this programming language comes with standard internet modules that allow Python programs to perform a wide variety of networking tasks in clients as well as server modes. Scripts can communicate over sockets, extract form information, send to server-side CGI scripts, transfer files by FTP, parse and generate XML and JSON documents, send, receive, compose, and parse email, etc. Third thing it is capable of doing is component integration. Now, Python's ability to be extended by and embedded in C and C++ systems makes it useful as a flexible glue language for scripting the behavior of other systems and components. Now, for instance, integrating a C library into Python enables Python to test and launch the library's components, and embedding Python in a product enables on-site customizations to be coded without having to recompile the entire. The third being database programming. For traditional database demands, there are Python interfaces to all commonly used relational database systems like Sybase, Oracle, Informix, ODBC, MySQL, PostgreSQL, SQLite, and more. The Python world has also defined a portable database API for accessing SQL database systems from Python scripts, which looks the same on a variety of underlying database systems. Another feature being the rapid prototyping. Two Python programs, components written in Python and C look the same. Because of this, it's possible to prototype systems in Python initially and then move selected components to a compiled language such as C or C++ for delivery. Now, unlike some prototyping tools, Python does not require a complete rewrite once the prototype has solidified. Parts of the system that don't require the efficiency of a language such as C++ can remain coded in Python for ease of maintenance and use. The next being, and the last obviously, numeric and scientific programming. Now, Python is also heavily used in numeric programming, a domain that would not traditionally have been considered to be in the scope of scripting language generally, but it has grown to become one of the Python's most compelling use cases. Prominent here, the NumPy high performance numeric programming extension for Python. By integrating Python with numeric routines coded in a compiled language for speed, NumPy turns Python into a sophisticated yet easy to use numeric programming tool that can often replace existing code written in traditional compiled languages such as Fortran or C++. Additional numeric tools for Python support animation, 3D visualization, parallel processing, and so on. Now, here you can see there are certain facts about Python. Now, as we discussed in your previous video session, Python was developed by Guido van Rossum in December 1989 in the Netherlands. And the name of the language, Python, was named after famous British comedy group Monty Python and Holy Grail, keeping in mind that Python is fun to use. Now, let's discuss the zen of Pythons. As you can see, beautiful is better than ugly, explicit is better than implicit, simple is better than complex, complex is better than complicated, and readability counts, of course. So very big names among users of Python, which includes Google, YouTube, Dropbox, BitTorrent, iRobot, Netflix, NASA, and many more. So trends show that Python is the most demanded language of 2014. If you can look at the chart given on the right hand side, you can see that Python is the most demanded language of 2014. Almost 30.3% of demand is grabbed by the Python programming language, which is the most popular coding languages of 2014. Now, most people find that Python to be easy to learn and fun to use, especially when compared with its contemporaries like Java, C# and C++. Why? Because first of all, it is simpler and easier to use than Java and C#. Because as we discussed in your previous video session, Python uses most of the English keywords and it is lesser syntactical as compared to these alternatives. And for the same reason, it is more readable than Perl. It is simpler and higher level than C, despite the fact that it is easier to learn and easier to use. And it is also simpler and easier than its another contemporary, which is C++, which is also an object-oriented language. And it is also more readable and general purpose than PHP and JavaScript. So it stands high among scripting languages as well. So among that also, it is more readable and established than Ruby. And it is more powerful than TCL. So these were the various advantages and facts about Python. We'll move ahead in our upcoming video sessions. That's it for this video.